This morning we want to continue on talking about our signs of Christmas. How many of you know that there are signs of Christmas? We've talked about the manger quite a bit the last couple of weeks and things that have happened there. But there are signs to Christmas, aren't there? Have you ever went by someone's home and it's the middle of July and they still got their Christmas lights on? Huh? You see it, don't you? And what do you think right away? Well, those are Christmas lights. What are they on for? It's not Christmas. You think that, don't you? But you reflect to things that are happening. I see evergreens all the time, and you know they're about yay tall, beautiful shaped trees. The first thing I think of is, boy, that would be a beautiful, beautiful Christmas tree. And in my heart, a three-letter word starts to bubble. Joy. Joy. You know, I can be upset, be disgusted, have all these things happening, but the joy that Christ gives us is still alive. Our joy is not based on things that happen about us. The little word joy we find in Christmas carols. Joy to the world. That's our song. We have a fella at the shop who's handicapped, and this time of the year, 4 days a week, we have special songs. And we had manger. And we had tree, and we had chestnuts roasting. And I'll start singing, and Ron will chime in with me. He'll be tooling around the shop in his wheelchair, and whenever he comes by, he'll sing a little bit of a song, and I'll bust in voice with him, and we just have a wonderful time. And I told him, Monday coming up, our word is joy. So we're going to be singing joy to the world all Monday long. Make people smile and laugh and get disgusted with us and everything else. But we also have that song, Oh Come All Ye Faithful. What's the next word? Joyful and triumphant. Oh come ye to Bethlehem. Amen. But I cannot help but wonder this morning, how many of us are really feeling joyful this morning in our hearts? Things sometimes go on that pull us back. And sometimes that is a trap of Satan to preoccupy our minds with all this stuff. That joy, that little fire we have in our heart starts getting covered up and dwindled down. And it's our choice to remove that blanket and let that joy come forward. William Willimon, Dean of the Chapel at Duke University, says this, that joy can be a challenge to the church. Sometimes all they talk about is the imperatives of life. Do this, don't do that. I believe churches sometimes go overboard on being so strict. And part of the problem is we forget about that joy. We forget about the joy factor. We forget about every single person is important. It doesn't matter how young they are or how old they are. Every single person has a place in the church today and should be important to everything. We should have that joy in our hearts that even though we walk through stuff, that love for Jesus, that love for for our churches, that love that only comes from God above is a sign of joy and allows us to overcome and walk in a way that makes people question. I've heard they say to Carolyn when I go skipping through the shop, they go, "That's really your pastor?" I told the owner of the company the other day, he goes, "You know, you're never here. I come to see you and you're never here, but if I listen, I can hear you." I told him, "I'm a cheerleader." I share joy with folks who are going through things because everyone is important. Amen? If all we had to think about for Christmas was Luke chapter 2, verses 8 through 20. This is the words we would see. "And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flock at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, 'Do not be afraid, for I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger.' Suddenly a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, 'Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his Father rests.' When the angels had left them and had gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, 'Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about.' So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which they were just as they had been told." Let's pray. Father God, we thank you this morning, Lord. We thank you for this precious account of the announcement of our Savior's birth. Lord, we thank you that when the angels came and the shepherds were so afraid, they shared with them the great joy that would rest on all who would ever believe throughout the entire world, forever and ever. Lord, we just ask that you be with us this morning as we look into your scriptures. Be with us through this time of worship. And Father God, we thank you again for your Son, Jesus. And it's in his name we pray. Amen. I seen this quote this week from Dean Wilman where he says, "Christmas is a delightful disruption of the way things normally go." Think about that a little bit. Christmas is a delightful disruption. Shepherds were minding their sheep, leading them out in the fields. And all of a sudden, this huge angel appears to them. Disruption. The Bible tells us they were scared. Not sure it was delightful, but it definitely was a disruption. But what did he say? "Peace on earth. Goodwill to men." Think about that a little bit. You know, I was picking on Lynn Friday night. I'm not sure where she went, but I was picking on Lynn Friday night, and I told her, you know, one Christmas carol a Sunday is enough. We don't need all these Christmas songs. And my mom frowned at me. She said, we do. It comes once a year. And Becky chewed on me a little bit, and Deb jumped in on the scene, and they informed me I was overruled. But what does Christmas Carol speak to us? The joy of our Savior's birth, the announcement of our Savior. It brings us joy. And we should be happy to sing Christmas songs, Dan. You should be happy. Christmas songs also speak to us about the prophecy of His coming. Those shepherds knew someday this would happen. We see in 1 Samuel 16 where they disclose to us the city of David. Chapter 16, verses 1 through 3 says, the Lord said to Samuel, how long will you mourn for Saul, since I have rejected him as king over Israel? Fill your horn with oil and be on your way. I am sending you to Jesse of Bethlehem. I have chosen one of his sons to be king. But Samuel said, how can I go? Saul will hear about it and kill me. The Lord said, take a heifer with you and say, I have come to sacrifice to the Lord. Invite Jesse to the sacrifice, and I will show you what to do. You are to anoint for me the one I indicate. You see, when this Saul went, Samuel went, he knew Saul was very upset because he wasn't chosen as the next king. But Samuel went and he followed everything the Lord had said. And he invited Jesse. Where was David? Out with the sheep. Where were these shepherds? Out with the sheep. What are we called? The sheep. Who's with us every day? Jesus, the great shepherd. Do you see the significance that all puts together? When Jesus was born in Bethlehem, many think it was off the beaten track. However, all the Jews knew that the Messiah would be born there. It's told. Matthew 2 tells us that when the Magi came joyfully to Herod in Jerusalem, they asked, where is he who is king of the Jews? For we have seen the star in the east and have come to worship him. Now Herod wasn't happy about that. But these wise men had came to find the Savior of the world. Micah 2 tells us, but you, Bethlehem, Ephrathah, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me one who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from the old, the ancient times. Herod knew this. The Jewish rulers knew this. Things were happening. Things were unfolding. And it had people a little nervous. Think about today. Think about our world today. Things are unfolding. Things are happening. And people are nervous. From health care to from health care to Social Security to the security of 401ks to retirements to pension plans, we are all nervous about what will be in 5 years. It's no different than back then. They were nervous about what was happening. Maybe even felt somewhat threatened about what was happening. But where was their joy. The angel said, I bring to you great joy for all who will believe. Joy in which our Father in heaven has created for each and every one of us a plan of salvation. That in no matter what life we have had, that plan of salvation is intact and available for all. God knew we couldn't succeed on our own. He knew it was hopeless for him to continue on with laws and all these things. So he sent himself as a babe, lying in a manger, with the name of Jesus, to bring eternal hope and peace and joy to all who would believe. Think about that this week. When the cookies are burnt in the oven, and you're out of milk, and there's a foot of snow on the road, think about that true joy that's alive in your heart. And do cookies really, really matter? We can make more, can't we? Think about that joy. I ran across this video this week. I was going to play for you, Joy to the World, but the wife didn't think it was it was kind of rocky. So we come up with this one instead, and I enjoy this as well.
Like a drama unfolding, the curtain was opening, while an audience of angels was holding its breath. A census, a manger, two travel-worn strangers, the stage was finally set. Angels folded their wings at the throne worshiping, as God whispered, I love you, my son. Jesus took off his crown and laying it down, said, Father, thy will be done. Oh, the time had now come for God's only son to be born as a light in a dark, lonely place. So he stepped from heaven's hall to Bethlehem's stall, where a star lit his newborn face. Tears, play the trumpet, the horns, and the strings, and tell the shepherds and wise men and all who will hear, command all of the angels to sing. Fill the sky with your voices and sing. And they sing. Joy, joy.
Jesus came to bring joy. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you, Lord, this morning. We thank you for this service and our time together, Lord, of worship. We ask, Father God, that you restore in us this joy that your Son Christ has brought to each of us. The joy of knowing our place is with you, Lord, and that our home is in heaven. Just be with us now, Father God, as we continue through our services today. Be with those who will cast ballots, Lord. We ask that they do this joyfully, Father God. We thank you, Lord. We ask that you be with those who will be here this evening, Father God, worshiping you through the live nativity. Just let us be a sign of joy to this community. We pray this in Jesus' precious name. Amen. And amen. Thank you so much, folks.